Hey guys, in this video I'm going to go over this linear algebra proof. It says let A be two n by n matrices. Suppose that B is invertible. Prove that the determinant of B inverse times A times B is equal to the determinant of A. So this is a very short proof. Before I go into that, let me just go over some of the properties you need to know in order to solve this or to prove this. So the first one, inside the determinant parentheses, you have matrix multiplication. So one property of matrices is that they are not commutative, which means you can't change the order of multiplication and expect to find the same result. So if you have a matrix A and a matrix B, it's not necessarily the same as the matrix B times the matrix A. So the order does matter when you're multiplying, and this is not the same as for scalars. So if you have the value A and the value B, let's say A is 3 and B is 2, then that would be the same thing as multiplying 2 times 3 is the same as multiplying 3 times 2. So matrices are a little bit different when you're multiplying than scalars. However, there is a property for determinants, which are scalar values, that the determinant of BA is the same as the scalar multiple of the determinant of B times the determinant of A. And since these are each scalar values that you're multiplying, that's the same as the determinant of A times the determinant of B. And just like we separated it and changed the order, you can regroup it to say that that's the same as the determinant of A, B. And another property we're going to use, this is pretty basic, but B inverse times B is equal to the identity matrix. And the size of this matrix is the same as the matrices that you're multiplying. So if B is an n by n matrix, then the identity will be the size n. Alright, so with those properties, we can now go ahead and solve this proof pretty simply. So proof, let's take the left-hand side that we're given and try to change it into the right-hand side to be equal to the determinant of A. So first I'm going to separate all of these values. So the determinant of B inverse AB is equal to the determinant of B inverse times the determinant of A times the determinant of B. This is equal to, if I switch the order, the determinant of B inverse times the determinant of B times the determinant of A. And now I'm going to regroup the determinant of B inverse times the determinant of B to be the determinant of B inverse times B times the determinant of A. B inverse times B is equal to the identity matrix. So this is equal to saying the determinant of an n by n identity matrix times the determinant of A. Oh, I forgot there's another property. For any size identity matrix, the determinant of I for any n in the naturals is equal to 1 always. So we know that this is equal to 1 times the determinant of A, which is equal to the determinant of A. And now we have the left-hand side, the determinant of B inverse AB is equal to the right-hand side, the determinant of A. So we're done with this proof.